PrivateerFX, coming at you 22nd of October. Just drinking my coffee there. Trying to make some sense of this foreign exchange market. We've had 2 weeks where the euro has just been between sort of 114.5, 116.5. Cable's been flopping around between 130 and 132. Euro yen's been up, been down, and here we are right near 130 again. Taking a look, what we like today or what we like this week is we want to sell high ones in BTPs. We had a very squeezy day on Friday, 121.15 the high. We tried to sell on Friday, ended up scratching it. We will try and sell again today, high ones, 120.60 and 121.60. Try and get a core short. There's some questions in the media over the weekend about growth in Italy. So now we have questions about not only growth, we have questions about debt. Doesn't look good to me over there. And you combine that with the entire global bond complex of prices lower, yield higher. Certainly Italy's not going to buck that trend either. So you have a lot of things in play here that lead us to believe that BTPs are a good core short. Let's take a look at some of the positions we had on Friday. Dollar MEX worked out pretty well. We traded all the way up to 1935. The key point was 1920. We had good acceleration through that. Looks to me that today will be a core long. So you can add back into 20 and probably add at 18 for continued higher in dollar MEX. Aussie yen, a little more tricky. On Friday, we did squeeze up to 44, but here we are, back at the figure. This is an interesting level for us, and we're kind of preparing for it, 79.50. This will happen if we get more risk off. Equity's now 27.71, dancing around this 200-day. We keep an eye on 79.50 in Aussie yen, and our core shorts here are in preparation of this being a potential break trade. As far as the big stuff, we don't really have a dog in this fight in euro. We had a squeeze on Friday. Might have a double bottom here at 114.35. This is the neckline up here now, 116.24. We're not really doing anything with this here at 115.15. Euro yen, big stupid squeeze on Friday. This could probably squeeze a little bit more. It makes no sense to us at all. We're not positioned. We will be selling this near 130.50. So these highs here. So if you just take a step back and go, if you are short and you're sort of a medium term guy, where's your stop going to be? It's going to be at 130.55. And that will be some sort of shameful squeeze, some sort of silly, stupid squeeze. And we will fade high numbers up there if we see it. It's still 90 points away, so nothing to get super excited about. But this looks like it may squeeze higher. I'm not sure how, which leg is going to take it. But we are bears in euro yen, and we will look to reload. Prices around 130.55. What else is there? Dollar CAD. We get the BOC this week, Wednesday. I think they're going to raise rates, so that should be good for the CAD. We had quite a weak CPI on Friday, so that actually adds conviction to they will not raise rates. I still think they will raise rates, but there is reason to believe that they won't. Anyway, We broke this 130.88 on Friday, and we've kind of been above it ever since. The hourlies here, I guess we got down to 82. This could go either way. If you do think they're going to raise, you want to be selling this back down through 130, say 80, and try and help squeeze out some of the longs that were put on Friday. But just something to keep in mind, this sort of a big pivot day this Wednesday when the BOC decides about rates. We're not 100% sure where we're going to go on this yet, but we will be looking for ways to get long CAD, as we think Bank of Canada is going to raise. Not sure where yet or how, whether we're going to sell high ones or sell momentum as it goes lower, but this is something we'll be watching. Speaking of watching, as everyone knows, the South African budget is out this week. You know, we're going to go into the budget square, and we're going to trade it momentum as a news trade. Historically, they tend to screw this up. There's a chance that they screw it up again. I say there's a pretty good chance they screw it up again. But of course, they know historically that they have screwed this up. And some of the media and some of the research that I've read is, is saying that, South African Reserve Bank is collaborating with the government and trying to help them say the right things. So we're going to go into this square with a heavy bias for higher dollar rand. See what these guys have to say, and even if they say the right things, you might have knee-jerk down, but nobody really believes that growth is okay in South Africa, and that they're not going to have to sell more bonds to try and goose the economy out of this recession. So the worst is not over in this currency pair, and this is actually a pretty darn good level to get short ZAR. But we don't want to jump the shark on this one, so we'll quietly wait. We'll wait, lurking in the bushes. Aussie yen, we have this core short we're working on because we think 79.50 will be a break trade at some point. Could be today, could be tomorrow. You'll see what we're looking at here on the dailies. We've been basically 79.50, 80.50 now for about 7 days. So this range has to be reconciled one way or the other. We feel the downside is the one that will be at risk. Finally, dollar max did what we asked it to do on Friday. It's now well above 19.20. This is a buy on dip. Probably visit 1920 today to take out some week longs. This is a buying opportunity for those of you who missed it on Friday. Maybe put a bid in at 20, put a bid in at 18, and then look for higher prices, move towards 1950, 60. I've said enough on this cold and dark Monday. Wish you guys the best, and